What is going on, everyone? It's March Jigade here bringing you guys news in the flash. Let's get into it. Starting things off, we have some pretty insane allegations being made against band members of Decapitated after a woman claims that they had kidnapped her on their tour bus in Spokane, Washington, and then proceeded to gang rape her in a bathroom. The court document that was released states that the woman came on the tour bus of her own free will after she and a friend were invited to come have drinks following the band show. At some point during the night, the woman allegedly felt uncomfortable and wanted to leave after apparently the drummer of the band grabbed her breast. She signaled to her friend that she wanted to leave, then got up to go to the bathroom, and after she got out of it, the singer of the band allegedly began kissing her, and when she told him that she needed to leave with her friend, she was told, "You have to have fun, she has left you," to which she forcefully tried to leave, and the singer grabbed her, spun her around to where she was facing the bathroom sink and mirror, to which she says that she used to see each of the band members taking turns raping her. The friend, meanwhile, was being pushed and held to the ground after she refused to give oral sex. These are all very, very disgusting and disturbing things, but there's a couple of things that we have to go over first. Now, the only reason that I'm bringing this up is because this is the part where things start getting just a little bit fishy. Eventually, the friend is actually able to leave. She leaves the bus, she leaves the venue, and she's driving to wherever she's going. She's later then pulled over on suspicion of drunk driving, and as she's being arrested in the back of a patrol car, she was allowed to call her friend. After that, she then proceeded to report that her friend had been raped. Police then found this woman 2 miles away from the venue and then took her to a hospital for sexual assault examinations, where detectives did note that she had significant bruisings on her upper arms consistent with that of being restrained. The band members were, meanwhile, being interviewed by detectives from Los Angeles County Sheriffs as they had already left Spokane, Washington. The singer says there was a party on the bus and that the women were present. The drummer told investigator that he had no idea who these girls were. The guitarist of the band actually told him that he had seen the singer and bassist engage in sexual activities with these women. The bassist, on the other hand, says he was on the couch doing nothing at the time, but that he had seen the women on the bus. He and both the singer both refused DNA swabs and requested translators and attorneys. Now, that's not really much of a bother here, but the fact that their stories are all over the place is not a good sign. It's not so much them refusing to take DNA swabs because the police might try to turn that around and use that as evidence against them if they get a match, but their stories being inconsistent means that there are details that aren't being said. It is also important to note that their attorney, Steve Graham, has stated that there were witnesses that saw the women come on and go on their own free will, and that the band fully intends to fight these accusations. And I do want to say this because Metal Insider was too much of a little pansy to use an open mind and too scared of being accused of victim shaming by morons who don't understand the meaning of logic and evidence to come right out and actually say it. There is a strong motivation factor here for why the girls might have lied. Now, I am not in any way, shape, or saying that they did lie, but it does need to be addressed. And by all means, if it turns out that the band members actually did rape her, then their lives and careers deserve all the ruin that comes their way. And trust me, it will be massive. That will be the end of their career. But the fact that her friend not only left the venue without calling the police or reporting anything, and the fact that she got into her car and was later being arrested for a DUI, where it wasn't until that, then afterwards, she got off the phone with her friend that the claim of somebody being raped came up. Those are two very large red flags for me. I mean, you are either a really shitty friend to just straight up ditch your friend while they're being raped, or you just got yourself a pretty nifty get out of jail free card. Either way around, I'm very interested in seeing where this story goes, because this can go either way around in terms of how much details are being presented right now. I hope more details are revealed along the line, and I am interested in keeping you guys updated on it. I take pride in keeping myself open-minded on these kind of situations, whereas other people or other news sites worry about crossing the wrong person. I don't care about crossing the wrong person. I don't care about their feelings. I care about learning the truth, and that includes when it sucks. I'm going to leave a bunch of links below for you guys if you want to read up on this. With that being said, leave a comment down below letting me know how you feel about this entire situation, what you guys think about it. I'm going to keep an open mind with this. I'm not going to say, oh, well, I'm leaning more this side or more that side, because I don't know. I need more details on it. But I'd love to hear what you guys have to say. With that being said, let's move on to some other news. Architects has announced they are heading in a new awesome North American tour in February with support from Stick to Your Guns and Counterparts. This is a North American tour, so that includes you too, Canada. Anyways, if you guys are interested in checking out the dates for that, the links will be below. You guys remember when I said that We Came as Romans might be revealing details of their new album relatively soon? Well, the time has cometh, my friends, and announced it, they have. The album is titled Cold Like War and is set to be released on October 20th through Sharptone Records. The band has stated that the themes behind this album will be focusing on the internal struggles the band has faced these past couple of years and figuring things out. On top of that, they've also released a track list and a new music video for the title track, which you guys can check out below. And finally, to close off the episode, we have a couple of new music videos and songs for you guys. We have Marilyn Manson releasing a new single, We Know Where You Fucking Live. We have Green Day releasing a new music video, Too Dumb to Die. Mind you, it is a lyric video, but I did think it was pretty cool, so I included it. And finally, we have Northlane, who put out their new music video, Color Wave. Be sure to check out all of those if you guys are interested. Thank you all for joining me. Feel free to leave a like if you enjoyed the video, dislike if you didn't, subscribe if you want more, and I will see you all on the next one. Mars out. Hey Bungie, it's me again. Just calling to let you know that it's been a week straight since the launch of Destiny 2, and unfortunately, my copy is still not working. It's still dealing with major crashing issues, and I'm still hearing reports of other PlayStation 4 Pro users dealing with the same exact crashing issues. Now, I'm just curious if you are actually going to do anything to accommodate the PlayStation 4 Pro users who are dealing with these issues, especially since the raid is right around the corner, or if you are just going to ignore the situation and carry on. Because if that's the case, then I would love the opportunity to get together with you guys, have a nice chat, have a cup of coffee, and then proceed to shove this $100 limited edition box set up your ass for screwing us over. If that's possible, great, let's set up the times and stuff like that, see if it's feasible. But if not, oh well, I guess I'll see you next time. But I hope to hear from you guys soon. And I'll see you when I see you.